Good morning, all of you. My name is Dr. Kunal Giwala, PG 3rd, Department of Radio Diagnosis, Saraswati Institute of Medical Science, Hapur, UP. My paper presentation topic is Imaging in Mucormycosis, Recent Trends. Abstract, background and objectives. The purpose of this study was to describe common radiographic pattern that may be useful in predictive diagnosis of rhinocerebral mucormycosis. Method, we retrospectively evaluate the imaging and clinical data of 5 patients, 3 to 70 year old, with rhinocerebral mucormycosis. Results, all the patients present with sinusitis and ophthalmological symptoms, most of the patients had iso-intense lesion relative to brain on T1 weighted image. The signal intensity in T2 weighted image was more variable, with only one patient showing hyperintensity. A pattern of anatomical involvement affecting the nasal cavity, maxillary sinus, orbit, and ethmoidal sinus was consistently observed in all 5 patients. Our series demonstration a mortality rate 60%. Conclusion, progressive and rapid involvement of the cavernous sinus, vascular structure, and intracranial content is a usual evolution of rhinocerebral mucormycosis. In contents of the immunosuppression, a pattern of nasal cavity, maxillary sinus, ethmoidal sac, and orbital inflammatory lesions should prompt the diagnosis of mucormycosis. Multiplanar magnetic resonance imaging show the anatomical involvement, helping in surgery planning. However, the prognosis is grave despite radical surgery and antifungals. Keyword rhinocerebral mucormycosis, imaging, and radioneurology. Introduction. Mucormycosis is acute, fulminant, and often lethal opportunistic infection, typically affecting the diabetic and immunocompromised patient, caused by the member of the mucorrhizal family, including Absidia, mucor, and rhizoplus. Clinical presentation is non-specific, including headache, low-grade fever, facial swelling, and orbit, and paranasal sinus syndrome. When limited involvement of the paranasal sinus is present, survival rates are between 50 and 80%. However, when the brain invasion has occurred, mortality is greater than 80%. Because of this lethal nature, it must be recognized early and treated aggressively. Method. We evaluate the imaging and clinical data of 4 male and 1 female, 3 to 70 year old, with mucormycosis of the craniofacial area. 2 were diabetic and 4 had hematological condition and the concomitant immunocompromised state. All patients had MR imaging with 1.5 Tesla system. Both T1 and T2 weighted image were obtained, as well as T1 weighted image after IV injection of gandapentate. 4 patients had CT scan available for review. Image were evaluated for density, signal intensity, and contrast enhancement characteristics. The CT density was evaluated in non-enhanced image and compared with the muscles. The MR signal intensity was compared with gray matter on T1 and T2 weighted image. Gadolinium enhancement was graded on scale form known to mark. Clinical information about presentation, management, and evolution of the disease was obtained from medical history in all cases. Result, clinical present, all the patients present with sinusitis, ophthalmological symptoms. 3 patients had clinical symptoms of cavernous sinus involvement, including diplopia, ophthalmoplasia, and facial and plane numbness. CT findings of the 4 patients who had CT scan available for review. 3 had iso-dense to muscles, lesion with bone destruction. 1 patient had hyperdense lesion relative to muscles in non-invasive portion, suggestion secondary to obstructive changes. MRI image, most of the patient had iso-intense lesion relative to brain in T1 weighted image. The signal intensity in T2 weighted image was more variable, with only one patient showing hyperintensity. The rest of the lesion were either hyperintensity or iso-intense in long retentional enhancement pattern. One patient did not have enhancement of his inflammatory process after the administration of gadolinium. 2 patients had variable enhancement with mixed non-enhancing and marked enhancing portion of their inflammatory lesion. 1 patient had mild enhancement and remaining patient had no enhancement at all. Dural enhancement was observed in 2 patients and mixed leptomeningeal and hemeningeal enhancement was present in another patient. Clinical evaluation, orbital extraction, ethmoidectomy, medical maxillectomy, and debridement of the nasal vault were performed in all patients. More extensive debridement of the necrotic tissue was performed as required in each particular case according to surgical finding. All patients received amphotericin B locally and parenterally. two patient recovered while three patient expired. Discussion: mucormycosis invade the wall of the blood vessels, resulting in vascular occlusion, thrombosis, infarction, as well as the dissemination to the central nervous system from primary focus. Spread to brain may occur via orbital apex, orbital vessels, or via cribriform grid. Generally, the presenting system was low-grade fever, sinusitis, facial swelling, orbital apex syndrome, blurred visions. Early visual loss would favor the diagnosis of rhinocerebral mucormycosis over bacterial cavernous sinus thrombus, in which blindness is a much later findings. We found that the MRI signal intensity of mucormycosis lesion trend to be iso-intense or hyper-intense in all segments. After the administration of gadolinium, the lesion had variable enhancement pattern ranging from homogeneous to heterogeneous or non-enhancing at all. We think that the contrast-enhanced T1-weighted image are helpful in delineating the intracranial spade when the meningeal enhancement is present, as well as identifying invasion of the cavernous portion of internal carotid artery by the disease. This had been previously described by Mohinder and associated with the show that the MRI can detect cavernous sinus invasion in the vascular complications such as ischemia. This is the image, coronal image of CT at level of maxillary sinus, nasal cavity. So large isodense mass lesion in right maxillary sinus extending into nasal cavity and ipsilateral orbit with bone destruction. Post contrast coronal image showing mucosal thickening of right maxillary antrum with large isodense non-enhancing mass lesion involving ethmoidal air cells. Conclusion: progressive and rapid involvement of cavernous sinus vascular structure and intracranial content is usual evaluation of rhinocerebral mucormycosis. Multi-modality image is helpful in promoting the early diagnosis when a pattern of nasal cavity, maxillary sinus, ethmoidal air cell, or orbital inflammatory process is present. Especially when the iso or hypo-intense lesion are observed, multiplanar MRI show anatomical involvement, which help in surgery planning. However, the prognosis is grave despite radical surgery and antifungals. This is my reference. Thank you.